Chairway 501, I'm in the NRC webcast portal, and I have a short little video that I thought was interesting. The affirmation session, Energy Solutions, Radioactive Waste, Import and Export, Energy Solutions Applications for Low-Level Radioactive Waste Import and Export Licenses. Maybe not.
Before we begin the ACRS meeting, we have one item for affirmation. Matt, do you want to proceed?
This is Energy Solutions, the applications for low-level radioactive waste import and export licenses. The Commission is being asked to act on a memorandum and order responding to two hearing requests and a petition for leave to intervene on Energy Solutions applications requesting an NRC license to import low-level radioactive waste from Germany for processing and an accompanying export license to return the resulting hearth ash and non-conforming materials to Germany. The Commission has voted to approve a memorandum and order which denies the hearing requests and petition to intervene and directs the Office of International Programs to issue the import and export licenses. Would you please affirm your vote?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Okay, if you want to come forward.
So I had no idea that we were importing nuclear waste from Germany, processing it, and then sending them back the ash. Wouldn't it seem that we have enough waste right here in the United States? Why are we processing other countries' nuclear waste? I don't understand. Somebody please educate me and enlighten me. Thank you. Okay, so normally I do my research before I make my videos, but got ahead of myself, so I went and did some research. Stop German radioactive waste imports for burning in Oak Ridge, Tennessee. This is dated 2/14/11, and the video I just showed you was on June 6, 2011. Tennessee Environmental Council citizens to end nuclear dumping in Tennessee and the Oak Ridge Environmental Peace Alliance submitted a formal request on January 27th to the Tennessee Department of Environment and Conservation's Division of Radiological Health. The petition asked for a public review of the impacts on public health and environmental well-being of the proposed expansion of the Duratec Bear Creek Incinerator, an Energy Solutions subsidiary. This expansion comes as Energy Solutions has applied to the NRC for a license to import 1,000 tons of radioactive waste from Germany for burning in Oak Ridge. The groups are concerned that if this plan is implemented, Tennessee will become a destination for radioactive waste from all over the world. Energy Solutions has previously applied to import 20,000 tons from an Italian nuclear waste to Oak Ridge for processing, including burning, melting, and compaction. Tennessee processors already received 75% of the nation's low-level radioactive waste, and that's some 41 million pounds per year. 41 million pounds per year. And now it's 20,000 tons of nuclear, Italian nuclear. And what came from Germany was 1,000 tons. Tennessee is the only state that routinely releases millions of pounds of materials from radioactive waste processors into municipal landfills every year, some 4 million pounds in 2009. Duratec, as a division of Energy Solutions, has responded that the request to expand its operation has nothing to do with their request to import more foreign radioactive waste. Essentially, the response to our petition for a public hearing amounts to a claim that they have plenty of radioactive waste to burn apart from the Energy Solutions request to bring in foreign waste. If so, it is even more important for the public to hear about the growth of radioactive waste incineration to which Energy Solutions now proposes to add foreign waste. Duratec and Energy Solutions wants us to sit down and shut up, but we think folks have the right to know more about this proposal to expand incineration of rad waste in our backyard. The Department of Environment and Conservation has not responded to the hearing request, but they actually did respond, and they rejected their petition for a public hearing. In its order, the Commission also granted a license to Energy Solutions to begin importing, transporting, and burning the radioactive waste. One of the citizens' complaints was that the waste is not well described, and another is the lack of a firm timetable to return the radioactive ashes to Germany. Let me go back down here. The groups are concerned that if this... Wait, I read that. Sorry. Be patient. I don't have my glasses on. Sorry. Incineration of radioactive materials is not done in most of the nation and the world, but Tennessee is increasingly becoming a destination for this practice. The Germans are a worldwide leader in toxic waste incineration, yet they seek to send their radioactive waste here to burn? If it is safe, why don't they burn it themselves? The Energy Solutions incinerators have been operating since around 1990 and have never undergone a comprehensive environmental impact analysis. They are licensed by the state to burn radioactive materials in any form as suitable for transport under Department of Transportation regulations. In light of the movement to offer incineration services to radioactive waste generators from all over the world, it is time for the state to conduct an in-depth health and environmental analysis of the issue, including air and water pollution, employee exposure, energy and water usage, and public safety. The U.S. Nuclear Regulatory Commission ordinarily does not consider issues of public health before granting rad waste import licenses, which allow tons of radioactive materials to come into our ports, across our highways, and into incinerators like those at Oak Ridge. It is up to the state to protect the welfare of its citizens, Safer added. I guess they even had a petition. So on January 19th, the state of Utah issued a notice of violation, a proposed fine to Energy Solutions for its action in importing waste into the state of Utah in violation of statute limitations. Energy Solutions related to waste generated by 5 different companies, 2 of them in Tennessee. The violations occurred over a 3-week period from February 26 through March 16, 2010. The violations involving Oak Ridge companies were classified as Severity Level 3 violations. The first, involving Bechtel Jacobs, asserts that Energy Solutions accepted 16 containers of waste in 8 different shipments that exceeded allowable limits for a Class A waste. The containers were shipped as Class A waste. The second violation, involving the materials and Energy Corporation, asserts that Energy Solutions accepted 3 drums of material containing special nuclear material or weapons-grade highly enriched uranium that exceeded limits by 28%. These violations are not isolated events. They appear to be business as usual for Energy Solutions, involving numerous source companies and spread out over 3 weeks. Oh boy. Energy Solutions has demonstrated that it cannot be trusted to do the simplest and most basic thing, to know what waste it is dealing with. To date, Energy Solutions has declined to provide detailed information about the waste they intend to import from Germany, either because they cannot or will not. This is unacceptable. It places the people of the state of Tennessee at risk. Okay, I will leave the links if you care to take a look at some of this. It just never ends. Just never ends. What is the job of the Nuclear Regulatory Commission? And now you know why I call them the No Regulatory Con Mission, because they are not here to protect us. They're here to protect the industry that they're supposed to regulate. Oh boy. Well, I have to look into this a little further and see what kind of updates I can find. As always, God bless. We need it.